गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ सुबोध सर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द दिल्ली सुल्तान्स। वी हैड बीन डिस्कसिंग एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अ लॉट अबाउट रिगार्डिंग द दिल्ली सुल्तान्स। जस्ट फॉर योर रिफ्रेश, the Delhi Sultan ruled from 1206 to 1526, and during this period almost 300 it was ruled by the five dynasties. The first one was the Sleep Dynasty or early Turkish dynasty, then followed by the Khalji dynasty, then Tughlaq dynasty, Sayyid dynasty, and last dynasty was Lodi dynasty. The first ruler of Slab dynasty or the first ruler of Delhi Sultan, it was Qutbuddin Aibak, and he had started the construction of Qutub Minar that you we see in Mehrauli in Delhi. At the time, the outer Delhi of Mehrauli that we are talking about was not the part of Delhi. Delhi was confined, if you visit, it was confined into the gate. Delhi gate, Ajmeri gate, Lahori gate and Kashmiri gate. At the four boundary, four side, the four gates are there. In between it, this area is called the old Delhi. And other the expansion now today we say the new Delhi. So these four gates, and if we see the Qutub Minar, it is very far off. In the words of the history, we can say it was in the hinterland, very far. Now it is in the Delhi itself. That's why I have given you the name Mehrauli. And why Mehrauli? It is part of now the colony of New Delhi. Earlier it was not the part of, when we are talking about the Delhi Sultans, quite back, 700 to 800 years back, we are talking about. So it was not the part. Delhi was confined into four gates. You may search, you may see on the map, find out the Delhi map. Political map Delhi, you find the Delhi gate, Ajmeri gate, Kashmiri gate and Lahori gate. And between the whatever Delhi you find among these four gates, it is the original Delhi that was ruled by these rulers. That is old Delhi. It is now still, if you visit there, it is very congested areas. It was ruled by the five dynasties we have talked. We have also discussed during the reign of Alauddin Khalji and Muhammad bin Tughlaq, in between these two, a weak ruler of Khalji dynasty and one of the Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq of Tughlaq dynasty came. But the attack of Mongols were much and frequent during the reign of Alauddin Khalji and the early part of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Mongols is a very much warrior groups. They were coming only to just looting the wealth from here and simply using it in their own countries. Means there was no motto to establish their role, earlier one in this phase, as we see. Their main target used to be temple, but now they started raiding and looting the wealth and taking this wealth to enormous wealth to their estate for the construction of food, for the construction of cities and other purposes. What happens when an invader attacks? It is very much clear that the ruler used to construct the fort, and fort is not used to be the very small, it used to be the big one. It was made in the areas which is not easily accessible, on the hill regions, on the such a terrains where the invader becomes invader to attack them. It was the main residence of the ruler as well as their officers. There are also some servants and other people are living. It is a big one, that's why it's named the fort. The wall, whole wall is very high, a steep rise. It is constructed in such a way. There is also a way to escape if it has been attacked and invaded. So they were protecting by constructing the fort. But fort cannot be made for all the peoples who used to live, the soldiers, and then get the name as the garrison town. Why? A ruler has to keep an army. Army was required for both the purpose. One is the defensive purpose, another one is the offensive purpose. What is the defensive purpose and what is the offensive purpose? Defensive means to protect themselves if the other attack on them. Hum apni bachav karenge. हम अपने बचाव के लिए डिफेंसिव मेजर के आप अटैक करेंगे हम अपने आप को बचा देंगे. ऑफेंसिव मेजर्स द क्वीन द रूलर द किंग बिकम्स वेरी मच कॉन्फिडेंट ऑन देयर आर्मी देन दे मे अटैक ऑन अनदर रूलर्स टू स्नैच टू लूटिंग द वेल्थ दे वर आल्सो कैप्चरिंग द पीपल्स एंड दैट पीपल्स वर यूज्ड एज अ स्लेव. A slave had many purpose. And since they were attacking, they were also increasing their territory, and if they are increasing their territory, it means their land revenue was increasing. Now, among the many rulers of the Delhi Sultans, Delhi Sultan also expanded. We have read in the chapter 1, we have revised in the previous video also. In the early phase, the area of, means early phase 26, we can say early phase of 13th century, the area of Punjab, Haryana and the land between Ganga and Yamuna, that is Doab. The land between two rivers is called Doab because it means two river, Doab, means matlab, land between the river is called Doab, it is a fertile. It means if we say it was very horizontal parallel lines, fertile northern plain, it was being converted. Then they started expanding, bringing more and more territory. We have also discussed about the internal expansion and the external expansion. In internal expansions, we have discussed that the forests were cleared, but all the forests were not cleared. They were increasing and clearing the forest, and this forest land was converted into agricultural land. That just we have discussed it. But most part were covered with the thickly forest. So it was difficult for the rulers to penetrate in this deep forest. I am saying because it was difficult for the ruler to control the area surrounding to them, because they were not aware of this dense forest. And the peoples who are living in the dense forest, they are habitual of the dense forest. They were attacking on it. Where they are hiding, it was not known. So the peoples were being attacked. So it was difficult to control the areas, means hinterland. Hinterland is the area which supplies the goods and services to the rulers, means around the cities, around the fort, around the port. And it was also very difficult to control the area which is very far off from the Delhi itself, Delhi to Bengal. So the far area, which is another state in the Pakistan, which is Sindh, another state. So this far reaching area was very difficult to control. To maintain them, step we have done that they had made the iktas, and the people who were given the responsibility came to be known as the iktidar. Who used to be made the iktidars? Generally, the slaves were made the iktidars because they were loyal to their patrons. But this was not happening to their heir of the patrons, because the slave was not as much as loyal to their son also. So during the reign of their son, these slaves might have or had revolted, and if they had become powerful, they asserted their confidence and their rule on the area where they were the iktas. That we will discuss later on. The new state become, it was not the end. After the Delhi Sultan, it was ruled by the Mughals, and after Mughals, during the period of Mughals in the 18th century, when the Mughals become weak after the death of Aurangzeb, many peoples who were the Jagirdar, Jamindars, they asserted their authority and made them independent. Today we will discuss about the two great rulers of the Delhi Sultans. One was the Alauddin Khalji. Another one was Tughlaq. Alauddin Khalji and Muhammad bin Tughlaq. One was from the Khalji dynasty, another one was from the Tughlaq dynasty. We have discussed the Mongols' invasion increased during the reign of Alauddin Khalji and the earlier rule of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. So we have discussed their policies.
It was the invasion of the Mongols and Alauddin Khalji used the army to protect themselves. Alauddin Khalji had the big standing army, and this big standing army was for the defensive measure to protect themselves. But Muhammad bin Tughlaq also had kept the big army, and he was also attacked or invaded by the Mongols during the early phase of his reign, but he used his army for offensive or attacking purpose, and he attacked the Transoxiana, means area from where the Mongols were
infiltrant into their countries. They have stayed for the other parts of the India also. It means big standing army of Alauddin Khalji, it was for the defensive measure, and big standing army for the Muhammad bin Tughlaq, it was for the offensive measure.
Now, to keep the big standing army, they had to make a town. So, garrison town was constructed. What was the garrison town? He made a garrison town, that is the Siri. If you see the map, you find Siri. Siri Fort Auditorium. Us jagah pe ban gaya, isliye uska naam Siri Fort Auditorium hai. It is Siri. It is outside the fort gates of the Delhi. You get the Siri. Instead of making a new town, it was a new town constructed by, made by the Alauddin Khalji for the soldiers, it was a garrison town. He, instead of making the town, the four cities of Delhi, among them one, it was Delhi and Pune. It was intact or vacated. After vacating it, it was being converted into a garrison town. Just see the difference. His army, big standing army for the defensive measure. His big standing army for the offensive measure. He made a new town that is called Siri. He did not make a new town, means garrison town. And instead of making, he vacated and entered the most city of Delhi, that is Delhi Kona, and converted into the garrison town. To maintain a big standing army, they required the grains or the land revenue. He just increased the land revenue up to the 50%. And he also, instead of increasing, he put the additional charges, and it was somewhat 50%, a little bit around it. It was also introduced, but it was successful, and his measure of it is had failed. Instead of giving the ikta were not given, they were given the salary. These people were also given, this is the same thing we find, the Muhammad bin Tughlaq also provided the salary. Now, salary had been given. Now, see the measures of the Alauddin Khalji. Salary was given, and instead of the ikta, so they can purchase their goods. From where they can purchase the goods? So, Alauddin Khalji made a market in the Delhi. And all the peasants and farmers were forced to sell their produce in the market at the rate prescribed by the ruler or the government. It means a farmer cannot charge more than this one. What would happen if they charge it? The espy of the King Alauddin Khalji were continuously moving in the market and supervising the prices. Not only the prices, the weight were also being supervised. And the punishment was very hard one. What was the punishment? If a seller or the merchant found selling the goods either at the higher prices than the prescribed or weighing less, then equivalent of the weight, if they are charging more, how much they are charging more, kitna jyada paisa lete hain, us jyada paise mein kitna grains aa jata, maybe 50 grams, maybe 100 grams. Or another way, if instead they are taking the charging the same price that is fixed by the government, बट इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट दे वेइंग लेस, एक किलो नहीं देके हो सकता है कि 950 ग्राम दे दिया. इट मीन्स इन ईच केस ही इज एबल टू सेव द 50 ग्राम्स. द पनिशमेंट वॉज वेरी हार्ड वन. इट वॉज नॉट द मॉनिटरी पनिशमेंट, इट वॉज द फिजिकल पनिशमेंट. एंड व्हाट वॉज द फिजिकल पनिशमेंट? इन स्टेट देयर फ्लेश फ्रॉम देयर बॉडी वेयर बींग कट इन द मार्केट इटसेल्फ. कहीं पकड़ा या कहीं से उसका पकड़ा, वो 50 ग्राम फ्लेश उसके बॉडी से काट लिया. सो पीपल्स वेयर नॉट डेयरिंग टू सेल देयर प्रोड्यूस. इट मीन्स द अलाउद्दीन खलजीज हैड कंट्रोल द मार्केट. बट मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक, ही डिड नॉट कंट्रोल द मार्केट. इंस्टेड ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग द प्राइस, ही हैड लेविड अ टैक्स टू इंक्रीज इट. एंड व्हाट हैपेंस? द एक्स्ट्रा टैक्सेस बिकम अ बर्डन फॉर द कल्टीवेटर्स, फॉर द फार्मर्स, एंड द नेक्स्ट कल्टीवेशन. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट ही वॉज होपिंग टू गेट द मोर रेवेन्यू, द रेवेन्यू डिक्रीज्ड. क्योंकि इस केस में फार्मर्स को पैसा तो फिक्स था कि इतना पे बेचना है, इसमें पैसा फिक्स नहीं था. दे हैव टू गिव इट एंड चार्ज बिकम एडिशनल चार्ज. इट वॉज मच मोर. इट मीन्स वी फाइंड दैट द अलाउद्दीन खलजी पार्ट वेयर द स्टेप्स वर टेकन, इट वॉज अ गुड बिकॉज ही वॉन्ट टू गिव मच बेनिफिट टू द सोल्जर्स. बिकॉज सोल्जर्स अ बिग स्टैंडिंग आर्मी, इट रिक्वायर्स द बिग रेवेन्यू, बिग ग्रेन्स, एंड इट इज नेसेसरी टू कंट्रोल द मार्केट. सो वी फाइंड दैट हिज पॉलिसी वेयर सक्सेसफुल. देन इंस्टेड ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग ही वेज इंक्रीज्ड एंड ही डिड नॉट कंट्रोल द प्राइस. ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द टोकन करेंसी दैट वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग एंड डिस्कस इन द इंस्टेड ही इंट्रोड्यूस द टोकन करेंसी. एंड फॉर दिस वन आई हैड गिवन यू द आइडिया रिगार्डिंग इट. He allowed the copper coin equivalent to the gold coin. Copper coin equivalent to the gold coin. So we have already discussed, told you, each house of the city of the Delhi become a minting house. Means they started minting the coin. And these people were very clever, they started exchanging it from the treasury of the rulers. इधर उधर नहीं, सीधा गए खजाने में, भैया ये दे दो, बराबर में ये दे दो. So gold coins, which was considered the wealth, was distributed among the subjects, and all the copper coins, which has a very less value, get deposited into the treasury of the rulers. So his policy failed. What is the difference that we find? He controlled the price of the market. Instead of controlling the price, he increased the token currency because he was thinking if the people have more money, they can purchase it from where they want it. No doubt it was not the bad idea. Today we are doing the same things. We have both things. दोनों चीज मेरे पास है, पॉलिसी ऑफ द अलाउद्दीन खलजी एंड पॉलिसी ऑफ मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक. कहोगे कैसे? देखिए, गांव में, शहर में भी पीडीएस सिस्टम है, पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम. नहीं समझ में आया? राशन की दुकान तो समझ में आती होगी. राशन की दुकान जो गवर्नमेंट राशन की दुकान होती है, वहां पे लोग जाते हैं, जिनके पास राशन कार्ड होगा वो सामान लेके आते हैं, उनका प्राइसेस फिक्स हो जाती है. इट मीन्स दीज पीपल्स आर फोर्स्ड टू सेल द प्रोड्यूस. नो डाउट दीज आर नॉट द फार्मर, दीज आर द पीपल्स हु हैव गिवन द लाइसेंस टू डू इट एंड दे आर परचेजिंग इट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट FCI गोदाम.
अब गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड करती है, गवर्नमेंट लाती है फार्मर से खरीद के एंड देन सेलिंग इट थ्रू द पीडीएस सिस्टम फॉर द पुअर पीपल्स हु हैज द लेस मनी. And this system is also available token currency because the government servant other people's business because who have the money they can purchase the goods and the services from anywhere they wish because they have the currency. And still we don't have the currency, we have the token currency. In fact, we say we have the token currency. If you have the 500 rupees note, if you have the 2000 rupees note, if you have the 100 rupees note, it has the face value, it is written, the government agreed to offer the value equivalent to 500. उसमें लिखा रहा था, मैं धारक को 500 रुपया अदा करने का वचन देता हूँ. नीचे रिजर्व बैंक के गवर्नर का सिग्नेचर होता है. इट इज बीन प्रोमिस बाय द गवर्नमेंट. यहाँ भी प्रोमिस किया गया था, ये फेल कर गए उस टाइम. इसलिए कहा गया कि मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक शायद अपने समय से पहले जन्म ले चुका है. वी आर फॉलोइंग द सेम पॉलिसी, टोकन करेंसी भी है, बट ही इंट्रोड्यूस द टोकन करेंसी डिफरेंट. इट मीन्स टुडे वी कंपेयर इट. वन थिंग माइट हैव टोल्ड यू, द थिंग वाज दैट टू प्रोटेक्ट देयर कैपिटल एंड किंगडम फ्रॉम द अटैक ऑफ द मंगोल्स, ही शिफ्टेड हिज कैपिटल फ्रॉम दिल्ली टू Devgiri, which he renamed as the Daultabad. Peoples, he forced all the peoples to leave the Delhi and go to the Daultabad. They went there. In the way, there was no any facilities. Daultabad in the Maharashtra regions, just south of the Madhya Pradesh, you have Devgiri, find out Devgiri or Daultabad, you will find it. Ab Delhi se wahan tak jana, what was the source of traveling? For the common peoples, nothing. They were using their livestock, buffalo, and other animals, may have been horse if they had the. In the way, many peoples died, either they were the child or the old peoples. Many peoples died in the way itself. When they reached there, people started living. But they don't find it comfortable because they find it is the alien place for them. कहीं घूमने के लिए आए या मनी रखते ज्यादा नहीं कर सकते. Again, the Tughlaq has to return back to the Delhi. In the mean, another few people died. It means many people died due to shift of the capital. In the shifting, he has to make many expenses. Their expenses wasted. Time wasted, he has to loss of the many peoples also. So we can say the all the policies that were adopted by the Muhammad bin Tughlaq, it was a failure, and the policy adopted by the Alauddin Khalji, it was a success. And if we compare it from the today's, we find his policies should not be a failure. Because today we also pay the, he added the additional charges. We also pay the additional taxes. You may ask your parents that in the form of cess, this is an extra charge that government charging maybe 1%, maybe 2% on a product. On the product, charge is already there. If you are going to purchase the petrol, in petrol, the charges is already there. Among the charges, they charge extra charge in the name of the education and other purposes. That is called cess. It was introduced by Muhammad bin Tughlaq quite back 800 years back, 700 to 800 years back. At a time it failed, but today it is a successful. He introduced the token currency. At a time it was failed, today it is a successful. At that time, so we are talking about from that point of view, he was the failure, all his policy failure, and all the policies of Alauddin Khalji was successful. But if you see the today's view, his policy was not failure, his policy was successful.
But you people have to compare the administration of Alauddin Khalji and administration of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. It means you have understood it, you should go through the books very carefully, go through the videos, go through the book, the NCERT book. It would clear your concept. Thank you. Go through it.